I'm Dr. Isabella Wentz, your thyroid pharmacist and author of Hashimoto's The Root Cause, and I'm here today with my good friend Magdalena Shalaki. And Magdalena is a nutrition coach. I actually came across her work when I was on my own health journey and looking for people who were in the thyroid space, who were experts and could provide me with some value. And a lot of the things that I learned, I actually learned from Magdalena. And you know, just really glad to have you here with me. So thank you so much for the work that you do. And can you tell us a little bit about your own story?
Sure. So, you know, in short, I had Hashimoto's disease, and that was diagnosed in 2008 with very high antibodies. And it was quite a journey because there was no book like Isabella has today. There were no online resources and summits. And so it was a really tough journey. Fast forward, a lot of changes, especially nutritionally driven. I would say not the only thing, but you know, predominantly I would say 80% I attributed to nutrition, a bit of supplements, and a lot of detoxification and stress reduction. And I've managed to bring my antibodies down significantly, down to from over 1,000 down to 66. Yes. That's the last study I tested, and I'm working further to get it even down lower. But you know, my own disease became my journey. So yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah,
amazing. And you know, we're both from Poland, so we have that in common as well. We're both very passionate about health. One of the reasons why I'm here with Magdalena is because of some recent research I came across that was talking about estrogen and Hashimoto's. And so one of the things that can happen in if women with excess estrogen, this can actually trigger Hashimoto's in them. And Magdalena has been doing something really great over the last few years. She's been focusing on balancing hormones and estrogen dominance. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Sure. You know, so this is one of the very overlooked areas of hormonal imbalances. And so a lot of times, and also underdiagnosed, you know, as much as thyroid is. In short, if anybody who's experiencing very heavy PMSs, if you're having water retention, especially during this time of the cycle, women who are having a lot of, believe it or not, cellulite.
Cellulite
is estrogen dominance related. It could be very well. Anything from, you know, women having horrendous headaches before their periods. But also things like, surprise, surprise, maybe for some, thyroid nodules and thyroid cancers. One of, you know, things in my family, for example, breast cancer is an issue. And so breast cancers as well as breast nodules can be connected to estrogen dominance as well. Something that Western medicine doesn't tell us, and I think it's, you know, I'm just so passionate to get the word out because there are so many of us who have it. And I honestly don't know many women who don't have history of breast lumps and nodules, or thyroid nodules. And so, you know, so that is something that definitely can be connected to estrogen dominance.
Wow. And so how would somebody know that they have estrogen dominance? Are there tests that people can do, or is it just kind of a symptoms thing?
Yeah, so definitely a good physician would help us diagnose it with a combination of health history, right? Your mom's side especially, but also your lifestyle, as combined with labs as well as symptoms. If you talk about labs, you know, it's always good to look at something called 2-16 hydroxyestrone. It's a very simple test that most physicians can order through blood that can be done. I'm a bigger proponent of doing urine testing or saliva testing for sex hormones such as estrogen. For thyroid, no, but for estrogen and progesterone, just to see the relationship between estrogen to progesterone. That's an important part of determining. And so that's something that can be done. But, you know, the first one that I mentioned, most physicians can do it very easily. And for years, there's always been used as a marker for managing breast cancer risk.
Okay, great. So that's very, very helpful information. So then why is it so important for women with thyroid conditions to really balance their hormones and take care of their estrogen dominance?
Yeah, this is such a great question. You know, this is the biggest one, I think, for people who have a thyroid problem is that, you know, thyroid nodules are painted to be like a normal thing. Like, it's not a big deal to have a thyroid nodule. And I don't know about you, but having, say, a nodule in your hand, something that's visible, how comfortable would you be with that?
Right.
You know, most people wouldn't. They want to do something about it. And Western medicine doesn't offer any solutions. I feel like it's a dangerous space to be in to say it's okay to have a nodule and not do anything about it. And by rebalancing your estrogen, you can actually really get rid of your nodules, quite possibly. But also, you know, be as a prevention for thyroid cancer, which happens to be the fastest growing cancer in the United States. And it's something that changes people's lives. It's a simple thing we can do through nutrition to rebalance our estrogen levels that will really give you the peace of mind that your thyroid is going to be in good shape.
function. And then I know you've been doing something really cool. You've actually been helping people balance hormones with food.
Yeah.
You've got this seed rotation
yeah.
that you turned me on to. Can you tell me more about that?
Sure. So it's a very simple concept of using different seeds and the different parts of your menstrual cycle that help you rebalance your estrogen and progesterone. So the first part of your cycle, so if we're talking about from day one of your period to day 15, let's say if your cycle is 30 days, you just take the half point, day 15. So day one to 15, you want to help your body to produce more estrogen. And you can do that by introducing phytoestrogenic foods such as flaxseed and pumpkin seeds, preferably in the ground form. And then you want to switch over to foods that are supporting of progesterone production through zinc and vitamin E, and that will be sunflower seeds and sesame seeds. And so you're talking about 2 tablespoons per day of either one of them, or you can do a combination of both through these cycles, and it produces amazing results. For women who are menopausal, that can also be used, and you can just start off on any time of your cycle and do it just the same way, half month, and you know, when women who are menopausal still produce hormones, a lot of women don't know that. So you're still producing hormones, and you can support your body through the simple seed rotation technique to rebalance your also progesterone and estrogen. I have great recipes for your folks.
Oh, we love recipes.
Using seed rotation. Yeah.
Awesome. And so thank you so much for sharing that. I think everybody will find that helpful to help balance their hormones a little bit more naturally. Where can people find more information about the work that you're doing right now with hormones?
Yeah, so there is an upcoming workshop. It's called How to Use Food to Rebalance Your Hormones. And I would love to invite you to the workshop. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be a very intense an hour and a half of learnings. And before you get to join the workshop, I've got a little bit of homework for you to do, or get some inspiration and get a bit of knowledge. The bonus is going to be about seed rotation and recipes for these amazing crackers to help you rebalance your hormones.
Awesome. And I've had them. They're really, really tasty. So thank you so much, Magdalena, for being here with us. And I hope that you guys enjoy the workshop.
Thank you. I hope to see you there.